So today I am going to talk about cervical cancers, right? I have chosen this topic of cancer because cancer is one thing which puts such a fear and stress in a mind that कहीं कैंसर तो नहीं हो गया है, अगर ये हो गया है तो क्या होगा, what will be the longevity, how will I survive and all. So there are lot many queries, you know, which wander inside the mind. So that's why I've chosen this. And moreover, what happens is that in India, this is one of the leading cancers in females. मतलब अगर मैं इसका magnitude आपको समझाऊं तो like almost every 9 minute one lady is dying of cervical cancer. So this is that इतना magnitude है इस problem का. And it is to the tune of 6 to 29%. So that is why I have chosen this topic of a cancer cervix, so that a baseline knowledge of what it is, how it is caused, how it presents, what are the steps by which we can take to prevent it, if happens, what can be the possible treatment modalities, this one should know. राइट. सो कैंसर सर्विक्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वॉट इट इज, बेसिकली जो सर्विक्स होता है, जो फीमेल जेनिटल पार्ट होता है, उसमें सर्विक्स इज द माउथ ऑफ अ यूट्रस. सो इट इज अ यूट्रस, इट इज अ सर्विक्स एंड द वजाइना. सो सर्विक्स इज अ माउथ ऑफ अ यूट्रस. सो वेन द एबनॉर्मल सेल चेंजेस स्टार्ट हैपनिंग एट द लेवल ऑफ द सर्विक्स, इट इज नोन एज अ सर्वाइकल कैंसर. राइट. नाउ हाउ इट प्रेजेंट्स, first of all, generally by the time this cancer cervix gives a manifestation, the stages are very very late and the treatment ke jo options hote hain, obviously wo thode se critical level pe chale jate hain, radiotherapy, chemotherapy and all. So we have to put stress on the symptoms which are little vague, but yes, if they are there, you must seek consultation so that the proper investigation can be done. So what are they? The patient can present with an unusual bleeding. Unusual bleeding mein kya ho jayega? Intermenstrual bleeding, postcoital bleeding and postmenopausal bleeding. So first of all, unko explain karne ke liye, let's talk about a menstrual cycle. So jo hamari menstrual cycle hai, that is around 28 days plus minus 7 days. Yani ke 21 days ka span normal, 35 days ka span normal. Anything falling within this range is normal. Aur jo bhi is ranges ke bahar ja rahe hain extremes mein, that all is abnormal. सो इंटर मेंस्ट्रुअल ब्लीड होता है कि वेन द ब्लीडिंग इज हैपनिंग इन बिटवीन द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल. मतलब कि आपके पीरियड्स खत्म हो गए हैं 4-5 डेज की, आपकी साइकिल ओवर हो गई है, बट देन अचानक आपको 10th day पे 12th day पे आपको स्पॉट दिखता है. तो येस, इन दैट केस इट द सर्विक्स हैज टू बी इवेल्युएटेड. देन द पोस्ट कोइटल ब्लीडिंग, दैट इज अ ब्लीडिंग आफ्टर द सेक्शुअल एक्टिविटी. So basically what happens is after the intercourse there should not be any bleeding. But yes, if a lady suffers from this problem that after the intercourse she's having spotting or she's having heavy bleeding, then yes, this must be evaluated. Then post menopausal bleeding. Menopause hota hai, jo India mein average age hai menopause ki, that is around 48 to 52 years of age. And menopause is defined when there is a absence of periods for 1 year. To agar uske baad if you have a problem of a spotting or heavy bleeding, then yes, the cervix, the endometrium, the ovaries all have to be re-evaluated. Okay? So why? Because this can be, I'm not saying that this can be a first sign suggestive of development of cervical cancers. Then it can present as a discharge. There can be a foul smelling discharge, although mostly the discharges are infective. But if a patient is coming with a complaints of a discharge, then we do evaluate cervix whether it is healthy or not. So in that way we do the inspection, examination and all. Then one can present with a pelvic pain, one can present with the symptoms suggestive of urinary tract infection like burning micturition or frequency of micturition. So whenever you are coming with that, we do a baseline checkup so that we see that yes, whether the cervix is healthy or not. Now you must be wondering, ये होता कैसे है, why this cancer happens, what is a causative organism behind it. So one thing is that this cancer is caused by a human papilloma virus. तो एक virus है जिसकी वजह से ये cancer होता है. Now this HPV, that is a human papilloma virus, it has many strains. It has strains as many as 100. However, the cancer causing strains are very few in number. they are known as a high risk HPV types. They are 16 and 18 and 31, 33, 35 and so on. So these viruses, if they get introduced inside the body of a female, they can lead to cancers. Normally हमारी body की immunity इतनी strong होती है that it is capable of warding off these infections within 2 years. However, these high risk human papilloma virus, they just percolates inside the mucosa, they start multiplying, they start producing changes at the level of the cervix, and once it start producing changes, so it takes around 10 to 15 years for the cancer to develop. सो बेसिकली अगर ये है और हम अपना प्रिवेंटिव मोडालिटीज पे थोड़ा ध्यान रखेंगे तो हम उस स्टेज पे पहुंचने से पहले ही इस चीज को डिटेक्ट कर लेंगे और टाइमली मैनेज कर लेंगे. बिकॉज जितना जल्दी डिटेक्ट होता है ना उतना फास्ट ट्रीटमेंट होता है और 100% क्यूरेटिव होता है. तो जो आपकी लॉन्गिविटी ऑफ लाइफ है उस पर बहुत ज्यादा फर्क ही नहीं पड़ता है. सो व्हेन वी आर सेइंग कि दिस इज कॉज्ड बाय अ वायरस, वी शुड नो what should we do now, what are the preventive modalities by which we can ensure that yes ye problem humko na face karni pade. So first is a safe sexual practices. So one must ensure that a safe sexual practices should be used. Try to use barrier contraceptives when you are going for sexual intercourse. Multiple sexual partners should be avoided preferably. Even if there are, then must use barriers. The sexual education should start at the level of the schools so that the baseline education to the kids are given and they are aware of the safe practices. Then comes the role of a pap smear. Pap smear is one test जिसमें कि हम cervix के mouth से watery secretions लेते हैं और उसको examine करते हैं कि whether this comprises of cells which are abnormal or not. It's a very very simple test. It's not painful. So the way we do internal checkup, at the same time we take a sample for this pap smear. Ideally, once a lady enters into this married life or into a sexual activity life, then one must get pap smear at least once in a lifetime. At least once. अदरवाइज अगर जो हम रिकमेंडेशन के हिसाब से बात करें तो जो फ्रीक्वेंसी होती है पैप स्मियर एग्जामिनेशन की, दैट इज इन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 21 टू 29 इयर्स, इट इज एवरी 3 इयर्स. सो एवरी 3 इयर्स यू मस्ट गेट योर पैप स्मियर डन. एंड इन द एज ऑफ 30 टू 65 इयर्स, एवरी 5 इयर्स. इट इज सेड दैट इफ योर रूटीन पैप स्मियर्स आर नॉर्मल, then after the age of 65 there is no need of further evaluations. However, if there was some pre-invasive things, then yes, the monitoring can be continued. So pap smear ek bahut hi simple sa test hai jisse hum ye jo cancer mein jane se pehle ki jo stage hai na, 10 years pehle ki jinko hum neoplasias bolte hain, CIN1, CIN2, CIN3 dysplasias, तो हम उनको डिटेक्ट करते हैं, हम उनको पिकअप करते हैं सो दैट दे कैन बी ट्रीटेड ऑन टाइम. देन अनदर इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज एचपीवी टेस्टिंग. नॉर्मली जो एचपीवी टेस्टिंग है, जब हम ये पैप स्मियर का सैंपल लेते हैं उसी में हम ऑर्डर कर देते हैं कि हाई रिस्क एचपीवी को टेस्ट कर लिया जाए. बिकॉज द लेडीज हु आर हैविंग अ इन्फेक्शन विद द हाई रिस्क एचपीवी, ऑब्वियसली दे नीड टू बी इवैल्यूएटेड एट अ फ्रीक्वेंट इंटरवल्स. मतलब दे मस्ट इंश्योर दैट येस एवरी 3 इयर्स, एवरी 5 इयर्स दिस हैज टू बी डन. एंड देन मे बी द फर्दर इवेल्युएशन. फर्दर इवेल्युएशन में रोल आ जाता है कॉल्पोस्कोपी का. विजुअल इंस्पेक्शन एक होता है एसिटिक एसिड से, एंड देन एक अदर एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी हो जाएगी कॉल्पोस्कोपी. नाउ वॉट इज दिस विजुअल इंस्पेक्शन ऑफ एसिटिक एसिड, इज दैट वी यूज वन एसिटिक एसिड जो विनेगर की तरह है इन पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, एंड वी जस्ट अप्लाई ऑन द माउथ ऑफ द सर्विस एंड वी सी द चेंजेस whether everything seems to be normal or seems to be abnormal. If it is abnormal, then yes, we must proceed further, maybe by colposcopy, maybe colposcopy directed biopsy and all. And colposcopy is like we see the cervix, we visualize the cervix under magnification. Magnification can be 10x, 70x and so on. So by that we get to know that how the cervix is looking, whether it has changes suggestive of early neoplastic changes or not. That's the main important role of this colposcopy, and it is very, very good technique in picking up the cases where pap smear presents abnormal cells. And nowadays vaccine is also available. क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया कि ये वाला जो कैंसर है वो एक वायरस से होता है, ह्यूमन पैपिलोमा वायरस से. सो लकीली वी हैव अ वैक्सीन अगेंस्ट इट. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के शेड्यूल में है कि द वैक्सीन हैज टू बी गिवन टू ऑल यंग गर्ल्स एज अर्ली एज 10 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, राइट? सो 10 टू 14 ईयर्स में अगर हम ये वैक्सीनेशन स्टार्ट कर लेते हैं तो इट इज गिवन इन टू डोजेस. देर आर टू ब्रांड्स अवेलेबल, सर्वरिक्स एंड गार्डासिल. So that decision will depend upon your practitioner, that how they'll counsel you and they'll tell you about the pros and cons of the two vaccines. But in the age group of 10 to 14 years, only two doses are suffice. However, after the age of 14 years or more, the doses are three in number. They are at an interval of 0, 1 and 6 months of duration, and Gardasil at the interval of 0, 2 and 6 months. So once you are given this vaccination, the protective efficacy is to the tune of 85%, right? So this is about vaccine. So every lady must undergo. कई बार आके कुछ questions पूछते हैं कि अब तो हम married हैं, now we are into this sexual life, will it be useful? Yes, it is useful, because it is not necessary that you have got the infection of this high risk HPVs. So once you give the vaccines, this protects you against the infection against high risk HPVs. Second, ek query hoti hai dimag mein, do we have to undergo pap smear before this vaccination? No, this is not a requisite, this is not a prerequisite. Pap smear and vaccination, ye dono alag alag cheez pe work kar raha hai. Vaccination aapko protect kar raha hai to the tune of 85%, aur pap smear humko detect karne mein help kar raha hai early neoplastic changes mein. So that is how both are different, and for vaccination one need not get the pap smear evaluated first. So this is all about the preventive modalities which are available. If it is detected at an early stage, and that's a very, very important thing, because this is one cancer which yes can be detected at an early stage if you are very much aware of the symptoms, of the magnitude of the problem, and you get the desired investigations done. Then very minimal surgeries are there which can help to prevent these cancers. For example, if it is just CIN3 and all, then we do conization. In conization means we just remove a part of a cervix, and you are healthy enough, you are carrying your normal sexual life smoothly, and there is no further risk. There is no hysterectomy involved. One can, but suppose if the stage is like stage 1 and or so, then one can undergo abdominal hysterectomy or laparoscopic hysterectomy. And generally, the longevity is quite good. It's the jo hamara survive 5-year survival rate hota hai, this is to the tune of 80-90% in stage 1. So, zyadatar cases hum koshish karte hain ki isi stages mein pick kar le. Because agar uske baad ki stage chali gayi, stage 2B onwards agar chala jata hai, तो फिर इट बिकम्स लिटल डिफिकल्ट. जो आपका 5-year सर्वाइवल रेट होता है वो काफी कम हो जाता है. एंड इसमें जो हमारे पास ऑप्शंस अवेलेबल होते हैं, देन दे आर रेडियोथेरेपी, दे आर कीमोथेरेपी, समटाइम्स सेकेंड लुक सर्जरीज एंड ऑल, राइट? सो व्हाट आई वांट टू ले स्ट्रेस ऑन इज दैट दिस कैंसर सर्विक्स इज वन ऑफ द लीडिंग कैंसर्स इन फीमेल इन इंडिया. एवरी 9 मिनट्स a lady is dying of it. It is very, very important that every lady must know and must get pap smear at least once in their lifetime. It's non-invasive, non-painful, and you must be aware of the vaccination. And if you are in that time frame, you must get yourself vaccinated. If you have young girls, like if you have kids and they are young now, after at the age of, beyond the age of 10 years, you must get your daughters vaccinated. In fact, abhi to studies chal rahi hai ki boys ko bhi vaccination hum allow karein kya, because it is responsible for rectal cancers as well and penile cancers as well. To wo bhi abhi aa jayega abhi researches ke baad na. एंड वन मस्ट काउंसिल द किड्स अबाउट द सेफ सेक्सुअल प्रैक्टिसेस, अबाउट द यूज ऑफ द कॉन्डम्स, बैरियर कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव्स, अबाउट डिस्करेज द मल्टीपल सेक्सुअल पार्टनर्स, डिस्करेज द हैबिट ऑफ स्मोकिंग एंड अल्कोहल, बिकॉज ये भी कहीं ना कहीं कुछ 1-2% ऑफ रिस्क में एनहांस करते हैं बॉडी की इम्यूनिटी को डाउन करके. सो इफ यू आर वेल अवेयर ऑफ वॉट इट इज, हाउ इट प्रेजेंट्स, प्रेजेंट्स में मैंने बताया था आपको बहुत वेग सिम्टम्स की तरह प्रेजेंट करता है, जस्ट अनयूजुअल ब्लीडिंग और डिस्चार्ज और पेल्विक पेन, तो कभी भी इनमें से कोई भी सिम्टम होता है प्लीज प्लीज गेट योर सेल्फ इवेल्युएटेड. So once you know that yes, this is the problem, this is how it presents, these all are the preventive modes available. So you can actually, once you go for consultation, you can discuss all these things with your practitioner so that you know you stay healthy. The things are detected on time, the things are managed on time, and you stay healthy, because ultimately life is very, very important, and investing on preventive health is a need of an hour. So I with this I'll wind up my talk. I just want you to understand that yes, pap smear is very, very important investigation, and every lady must undergo it at least once in lifetime, if not at the advised frequency. So be aware, stay safe, and stay healthy. Thank you.